of Investor Relations Unit at the regional and international level to promote Indonesia export. Bank Indonesia Rep Office collaborate with regional government to set up Regional Investor Relations Unit. This unit will coordinate with Bank Indonesia Rep Office all over the world. Government institutions such as Indonesia Trade Promotion Centers and all other related institutions. These cooperations aim to help penetrate global market by facilitating capacity building and foreign market introduction, business matching, and participation in international events. Lastly, digitalization. As we all are aware, digitalization nowadays expands rapidly and offers massive opportunity to increase productivity and to create new source of growth. Acceleration of productivity and digital infrastructure readiness is crucial to support Indonesia competitiveness. The disruptions posed by COVID-19 pandemic has also led us to embark on various innovation taking advantage of the digital technology. We all have witnessed how various business processes are digitalized swiftly. Numbers of micro, small, medium enterprises connected to e-commerce has increased during the pandemic period, in line with the change of consumer consumption pattern toward online shopping. Bank Indonesia, through its regional representative office all over Indonesia, continues to assist micro and small medium enterprises to adopt digital marketing and payment. On the marketing side, micro and small medium enterprises are facilitated to integrate into e-commerce. It is targeted that by the end of 2020, there will be additional 20 million micro, small, medium enterprises merging into digital marketing. On the payment side, micro and small medium enterprises are encouraged to apply non-cash payment instruments, such as use of Quick Response Indonesia Standard, or we are very familiar, so-called CRACE. The use of CRACE is boosted as safe means of payment in the physical distancing condition. The fast development of digitalization and amidst the pandemic has also led to emergence of new entrepreneurship. Many new home business flourished, flowing high laid off. On the regional level, the government of Central Java Province has also promoted entrepreneurship through the establishment of Central Java co-working space, the promotion of micro, small, medium enterprises product through the Governor of Central Java Instagram account, and conducting online micro, small, medium enterprises fair. Ladies and gentlemen, in the future, the dynamics of the global economy is still uncertain because no one can predict when the COVID-19 pandemic will end. However, with macroeconomic and financial system stability maintained, it is hoped that the domestic economic recovery will continue. Bank Indonesia, through its policy mix, will continue to strengthen synergies with the government and related authorities so that the various policy taken are more effective in promoting swift domestic economic recovery. Finally, I wish you all having a useful discussion as well as a good exchange of views from practitioners, government officials, and academics, both conceptually and practically. I do hope the seminar is fruitful for our endeavor in searching for innovative ideas, solutions, and strategies for restoring and strengthening micro and small medium enterprises in this pandemic period. We wish this seminar a great success. Thank you Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much for Mr. Dwi Prado for the speech. It's really needed that the program from Bank Indonesia and a financial institution to support the SMEs. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we are now continuing to the next agenda for a keynote speaker from Minister of Manpower, Republic of Indonesia. Please welcome the Excellency Dr. Ida Fauzia, MSE.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi, salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Salam Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, salam kebajikan. Yang saya hormati Vice Rektor Universitas Jenderal Sudirman, Bapak Profesor Dr. Hipnu Nugroho, yang saya hormati Kepala Departemen Regional Bank Indonesia, Bapak Dwi Pranoto, para pembicara seminar, para dosen dan tenaga kependidikan UNSUD, mahasiswa UNSUD, hadirin sekalian yang saya hormati. Saya akan menyampaikan sambutan saya dalam bahasa Indonesia. Pertama, marilah kita panjatkan rasa syukur kita semua kehadirat Allah Subhanahu wa taala, Tuhan yang Maha Esa. Alhamdulillah atas nikmat dan karunia-Nya pada pagi hari ini, di tengah segala keterbatasan karena pandemi COVID-19, kita masih diberikan kesempatan untuk berkumpul meskipun secara daring dalam rangkaian acara seminar Sustainable Competitive Advantage. Saya sangat mengapresiasi bisa berpartisipasi dalam acara pada pagi hari ini, karena acara ini merupakan kegiatan yang sangat penting dan mendukung UMKM kita sebagai ujung tombak perekonomian nasional kita. Hadirin yang saya hormati, usaha mikro, kecil, dan menengah Indonesia memiliki kontribusi yang sangat besar terhadap perekonomian nasional dan ketenagakerjaan di Indonesia. Tadi Pak Dwi Pranoto sudah menjelaskan. Berdasarkan data BPS yang diolah oleh Kementerian Koperasi dan UKM, UMKM Indonesia menyumbang hingga lebih dari 8.500 triliun ke PDB Indonesia.